We want to describe the type of transformation that would occur to the basic function f of x. We're given y equals 4 times f of x, y equals 1/4 times f of x, y equals f of 5x, and y equals f of 1/5 x. Looking at these first two, notice how we're multiplying f of x by a constant, where f of x would be the function values or y values. And since y values lie on the vertical axis, these two will either give us a vertical stretch or a vertical compression. But then for the next two, notice how we're multiplying x by a constant, which will then affect the input of the function. And the inputs lie along the horizontal axis or x-axis, and therefore in this case, these two will give us either a horizontal stretch or a horizontal compression. To better understand what's happening here, let's take a look at some notes and some graphs. Let's first consider y equals a times f of x, where y equals f of x would be the graph of this middle function here in blue. Let's first consider what happens when a is greater than 1, let's say a equals 2. Notice if we graph y equals 2 times f of x, the graph is vertically stretched. The reason it's vertically stretched is because in order to find the corresponding points on 2 times f of x, we multiply each y coordinate of the basic function f of x by a, or in this case, 2. So because we're multiplying each y coordinate by 2, we say this graph would be stretched vertically by 2. Notice how the function values of f of x go from 0 to 4, but the function values of 2 times f of x go from 0 to 8. Now let's consider when a is between 0 and 1, or more specifically, let's say when a is 0.5 or 1/2. Notice the graph of y equals 0.5 times f of x is vertically compressed because to find corresponding points on 0.5 times f of x, we would multiply each y coordinate of the parent function f of x by 1/2. And therefore we can say the graph of 0.5 times f of x would vertically compress f of x by 1/2. So going back to our examples, if we have y equals 4 times f of x, this will vertically stretch f of x by 4. And for y equals 1/4 times f of x, this will vertically compress f of x by 1/4. Now for these next two examples, let's consider y equals f of bx. Again, notice first in blue, we have the graph of the basic function y equals f of x. And now let's consider when b is greater than 1, more specifically, let's say b equals 2. Notice the graph of y equals f of 2x is actually horizontally compressed. Notice along the x-axis, the parent function goes from negative 4 to positive 4, but f of 2x only goes from negative 2 to positive 2. So it's actually half as wide as the parent function. Let's talk about why that makes sense. Notice on the parent function, this point here and this point here would represent when f of 4 equals 0 and f of negative 4 equals 0. But notice on f of 2x, the input would be 4 and negative 4 when x is 2 and negative 2 because the input is 2 times x. When x is 2 on f of 2x, notice that we would have f of 2 times 2 or f of 4, which would give us the function value of 0. And when x is negative 2, the input would be 2 times negative 2, giving us an input of negative 4. To find points on the function f of bx from the corresponding points on the parent function f of x, we'd actually multiply each x-coordinate of f of x by 1 over b, not b. So in this case, notice how b is 2, so we'd multiply each x-coordinate on the parent function f of x by 1/2. And because of this, we say that when b is greater than 1, f of bx will compress the graph of f of x horizontally by 1 over b. So the green graph is horizontally compressed by 1/2. And when b is between 0 and 1, let's say 1/2 or 0.5, notice how the graph is horizontally stretched. Notice how the red graph goes from negative 8 to positive 8 along the x-axis, and their parent function only goes from negative 4 to positive 4. The reason this should make sense again is because notice when x is 8 and negative 8, we would multiply these x values by 1/2 to determine the input into f of 0.5x. When x is 8, 0.5 times 8 would be 4. We know f of 4 is 0 from the parent function. And when x is negative 8, 0.5 times negative 8 would be negative 4. We know f of negative 4 is 0 from our parent function. So once again, to find corresponding points on f of bx, when b is between 0 and 1, we multiply the x-coordinates of the parent function by the reciprocal of b, or 1 over b. Notice here, b is 1 half. The reciprocal of 1 half is 2. So we'd multiply each x-coordinate of the parent function by 2 to find corresponding points on f of 0.5x. So going back to our last two examples, for y equals f of 5x, this will horizontally compress f of x by 1/5. And for y equals f of 1/5 x, for y equals f of 1/5 x, this would horizontally stretch f of x by 5, which again is a reciprocal of b. So for example, if we consider the basic function f of x equals x squared, 4 times f of x would be y equals 4x squared. Y equals 1/4 times f of x would be y equals 1/4 x squared. And for f of 5x, the input is now 5x, so we would have y equals 5x squared, or 25x squared. And for y equals 1/5 x, we would have y equals 1/5 x squared, which would be the same as 1/25 x squared. I hope you found this explanation helpful.